Time now to answer some of your pet questions this afternoon. Joining us today from Falls Road Animal Hospital, Chitara Jenkins. Hi, Chitara.
Hi.
And who is this?
This is Chloe. She's one of the patients at Falls Road.
And she's a service dog.
She is a service dog. She is an emotional support pet for her mom.
Okay. All right, let's get to some of the questions.
Okay.
How often does my Shih Tzu need to be groomed?
Shih Tzus, unlike Chloe, have hair instead of fur. And so ideally, if you're, you know, if you want to keep it long, you can, but you need to comb the fur out every day. Otherwise, I think it's recommended every 6 to 8 weeks to, you know, if you want to keep the hair at a certain length. That's about how fast it grows.
Okay. My kids are ready for their first pet. How do we choose what to get?
Fun question. So I think in choosing a pet, the first thing you need to decide is what level of like care and time do you have to commit to a pet. Dogs and cats are pretty easy, obvious choices, but even in picking a dog, they have different requirements as far as like activity, taking them for walks. There's exotic pets, snakes and hamsters and things like that. They all require a certain level of care, and you want to do a lot of research to figure out what that pet needs and if you're able to offer that to the pet.
Reminds me of the pet rocks. Sometimes you just need a pet rock.
Some families do just need a pet rock.
We have a family cat, but my son really wants a dog. Will they get along?
Maybe. Dogs and cats can get along. If it's an older cat, they tend to be more finicky about who they allow in their personal space. So ideally you want to get like a younger dog that's willing to take cues from the cat. If you're getting a pet from like a shelter, the SPCA, Barks, things like that, they allow you to like have a meet and greet with your existing pets first and make sure they're all going to get along.
Who's usually in charge, the cat or the dog?
Usually the cat.
Wow.
Like the saying, dogs rule, cats rule, it's pretty relevant.
Okay. Our 6-month-old poodle Mix gets sick and throws up on car rides. That's not good. Will he grow out of it?
Another maybe. So if it's a 6-month-old, there are things that you can do to kind of help the pet through it. When they're younger, taking them for shorter car rides, like I always recommend to owners, like just go around the block and let the pet out. Like it helps build up their tolerance for car rides. Another thing you can do is talk to your doctor about a medication for anti-nausea. If it's an older pet, they're probably not going to grow out of it. And so a medication that would control that is the way to go.
All right.